Pretty close in your ear.
All right, shalom, shalom. It's your good brother, Kahan Tazadaq. And this is Tazadoctrine. This is a short, this is not legal advice. I can't offer you any type of legal advice. If you need legal advice, seek yourself a competent counsel, then please be advised. The information I'm about to give you is strictly for educational information or entertainment purposes only. Are you awarded a state, a corporate fiction, a corporate construct? It's a question. The Internal Revenue Service Manual, right? The Internal Revenue Manual, IRM 21.7-13-3.2.2 states in pertinent parts that an infant is a decedent of the estate or guarantor, owner or trustor of a trust, guardianship, receivership, or custodianship that has yet to receive a social security number. End of quote. So brothers and sisters, essentially what this is saying is an infant is anyone under the age of 21 or whatever the legal age of majority is in your particular state of. So your mother allegedly abandoned you at birth, well, shortly after birth, should I say, when that live record of birth was signed. So have you noticed that your mother's address is already pre-typed in one of the boxes? Did you notice that? Have you noticed that there is no address for the father on the COLB, Certificate of Live Birth? Have you noticed that the address of the mother's maiden name is unmarried? That particular section? It's her maiden names in the box, not her married name, even if she's married. Why? Have you noticed that? Have you noticed the mother signed as the informant and not the father? See, brothers and sisters, you are considered an infant. An infant is a ward of the state, as your mother was the informant. An informant is a person who actually informs on another to the authority. She signed your record of live birth, allegedly acting as the trustee, as the executor, father's estate. So if she declared she was married, then the father and the mother are one in law, and thus the mother will have the same authority as the father. Do you understand? As executor. But as an unmarried woman, they assume she's acting as a co-executor of the estate, or in the capacity of the trustee, one with the authority to sign over a property. What was the property? Her son or her daughter, which became a commodity. She has none without her husband's approval, is what I want to tell you. See, in common law marriage, she has none. In civil law, she has no authority, right? We must also note that the line of the executor would actually fall on the nearest male relative, not a female. Not only is the mother without legal representation, but no male are listed. Am I lying? In fact, male relationships are left off the documentation. What do you think this is, brothers and sisters? There's absolutely no reason for the father not to be on the birth record, except for religion, right? Matthew 23, verse 9. Go and read that. And call no man your father on earth, for one is your father, even who's in heaven. That's the only reason you should not utilize the term father. The First Amendment clearly prevents the government from adding his name. It prohibits the making of any law respecting an establishment of religion or impeding the free exercise of religion. Knowing thus, the term father would actually impede the establishment of religion. So the state of New York, state of California, state of Florida, state of Oklahoma's very own instructions on completing the birth certificate, signature of a parent, have a parent review the certificate of a live birth for accuracy. Read the actual statement, brothers and sisters, contained in that particular section, and sign this section certifying accuracy of the certificate. What I suggest is that you ask only the mother to sign the birth certificate. It's right there in that section. Good, just go and read it. Never have a parent sign a blank or incomplete certificate. It states their important part. Go read Oklahoma State. Go look at the instructions for Oklahoma State birth certificate. Their instruction tells you only to have the mother to sign. Now, why would the Department of Health and Vital Statistics teach doctors, nurses, and hospitals, administrators to coerce the mother into signing the certificate of live birth instead of the father? This is something, all of you that's been doubting this, this is something that I really need you to muse over and think of deeply and then try to prove me wrong. You can't, because I give you pure, indisputable, irrefutable truth. Why are these doctors and these nurses instructed only to have the mother sign and not the father? That is my question for you today. Because, I'll give you the answer, it's rhetorical. Because the executor is the highest office of the estate, and the state does not care to deal with him. The man is the executor. They would rather go after the informant, trustee instead. Huh? F female. She's the informant trustee. She's not the executor. Attempting to administrate an estate without written authorized consent of the executor, I man. Why am I the father? Because I fat her. Father, fat her. Fat her with what? With myself. What is myself? Knowledge. This is right knowledge for them. So attempting to administer the estate without a written authorized consent of the executor is very costly. People go to prison. But if they can coerce the mother, who's the informant trustee, to sign over the property, then they appear to have a legal leg to stand on. However, it is all based on fraud. Keep as many people as you can ignorant, then you can have the blind leading the blind. I am Kahan Tazadaq, and this has been Tazadoctrine. This is a sure. Like, share, subscribe. Get your mind right, King, and talk to these informant trustees and help them get their minds right, because they're putting restraining orders and everything else as they can against the executor. Why? Because these illuministic systems want to destroy the executors. You can never be an executor in your female capacity. The system has lied to you. This is Tazadoctrine. Don't get mad. Get your minds right. If I offended you, I meant you. Shalom. Real men stand up.